Hey guys, how's it going? So in today's video, we are going to look at an ultra thin and light laptop. So this laptop is different from the other premium ultrabooks that are available in the market. And there are few reasons why I am talking about this laptop. One is that even though this is an ultrabook or an ultra thin and light laptop, it delivers about 10 hours of battery life. And there are no compromises when it comes to performance or port selection. This laptop is Acer Swift 5 series laptop. And there are two types of Acer Swift 5 laptops that are in the market, but the one that we will be looking at today is the 15.6 inch screen. So what I like about this laptop is that Acer has managed to pack in 15.6 inch screen size in a 14 inch body, and this is pretty amazing because if you compare the size of this laptop with other traditional 14 inch laptops, the physical size of the laptop is exactly the same, but you are getting much bigger real estate when it comes to screen. And Acer has accomplished this by trimming the bezels. So this laptop has a pretty impressive 87.6% screen to body ratio, and even though Acer has trimmed the bezel on the top and on the side, they have still put the webcam on the top center, which is the perfect place for a webcam. So a lot of other manufacturers, including Dell XPS 13 laptops, they used to have the webcam in the bottom, sometimes next to the keyboard, and that created that very awkward angle. And I never liked those laptops because nobody wants to use the webcam when it's like looking from under your nose. That's not a very pleasant angle. So this laptop has a very good full HD screen. So 1920 by 1080p resolution, and the screen is really bright. It's 300 nits of brightness is plenty for any kind of indoor use, be it like a very well-lit home office or office environment or a classroom. You will never have any problem with the screen. The screen is IPS panel, so it has very good viewing angles. It is also fully touch enabled, so it supports all the Windows 10 multi-touch gestures. So the hinge of the laptop will let you move the screen all the way back to 180 degrees, which means it's great if you are chilling on a couch watching Netflix or, you know, binging YouTube videos. Unfortunately, it will not go beyond 180, so you can't flip this laptop and make it 2-in-1. The build quality of this laptop is fantastic. This is not some cheap plastic laptop. It's magnesium alloy, and the use of this special alloy makes this laptop very light. It's under 2.2 pounds, but it's very solid. When you hold it in your hand, it feels very premium. There is no creaking, or it doesn't give in. The chassis feels very solid, and it's kind of surreal because when you hold the laptop in your hand, it is so light that the first time when I held the laptop in my hand, I almost felt like there was no battery in the laptop. It just felt like something was missing. But that's because it's like 960 grams. It's crazy light. So there are two flavors of this laptop that you can buy on Amazon as of today. One is the Core i7 flavor, which is the more expensive option. And this one goes for about $1,400. And then there is a cheaper option which goes for about $900. And this one is the Core i5 configuration. So if you look at the differences between these two configuration, in addition to the Core i7 versus Core i5 processor, the more expensive one comes with 16 gigabyte of DDR4 RAM, as opposed to the $900 version, which comes with 8 gigabit of the same RAM, DDR4. And the second difference is in the storage. The more expensive configuration will give you 512 gigabyte of SSD, while the cheaper one comes with 256 gigabyte of SSD. Now there are some things which you should note when it comes to the differences between these two laptops, because this being a thin and light laptop, it's not very easy to upgrade this laptop. So for example, I have reviewed some other Acer laptops, like the Acer Aspire series laptops, which are very easy to upgrade, and I made bunch of videos on those laptops on how you can like go and upgrade the RAM or the SSD. Unfortunately for Acer Swift series laptop, the RAM is actually soldered to the motherboard, which means you cannot upgrade the RAM. So when you are picking a configuration, you will have to decide how much RAM do you need. And if you buy, say for example, an 8 GB RAM configuration, then you are stuck with that. You cannot go and buy a memory stick and upgrade it. But luckily, when it comes to storage, you do have an option of upgrades. So I opened up this laptop, and as you can see here, Acer has provided an M.2 slot, which is right next to the battery. And I will throw a link in the description of a compatible SSD that you can buy and upgrade your storage if you are interested. So then the question is, should you spend more money, $1,400, and get the Core i7 version, or should you go with the cheaper $900 model? So let's look at the differences between these two configurations, and we will decide whether it's worth $500 extra So the first thing that we will look is the processor. So if you compare core i7 versus core i5, here you see that the core i7 and i5 both have the same 4 cores and 8 threads, but the difference is in the base frequency. So the core i7 is 1.8 GHz versus 1.6 for core i5, and the max turbo frequency is 4.6 GHz versus 3.9 GHz. So max turbo frequency basically is the ability of the processor to overclock one of its core to meet some high demanding job, and this is where you do see an improvement in core i7 because it can go all the way up to 4.6 GHz. Everything else, if you look here, is exactly the same. There is not a whole lot of difference in terms of the numbers. So now let's look at some benchmarking. So if you look at the CPU single thread performance, you will notice that core i7 is scoring 2343 points and core i5 is slightly behind, but not by much, 2145. And if you look at the CPU mark rating, which is the overall performance of the CPU, so you are taking into account all the cores and threads, the performance difference between core i7 and core i5 is about 11%. 8,918 points for core i7, 8,025 points for core i5. So here is the final result. You are getting about 10 to 11% performance boost for $500. And frankly speaking, that's really not, that does not justify spending $500. In fact, a 10% performance improvement you won't even notice in most of the day-to-day tasks. So if you are browsing or if you are surfing, you are watching your favorite videos on YouTube, Netflix, some word processing, Excel sheet, any kind of the office work or any day-to-day task that you are doing on your computer, 10% CPU performance improvement is not going to even show up. Just based on the CPU performance, I don't think it makes any sense to spend $500 to get the more expensive configuration. But that's not the end of the story, right? You have the RAM and you also have the SSD, and this is where things get a little interesting. So like I mentioned before, you cannot upgrade the RAM on either of these two configuration because Acer has soldered the RAM to the motherboard. So if you buy a 8GB configuration, you are stuck with 8GB configuration. So my recommendation is think hard whether you need 8GB or 16GB model and then pull the trigger based on that. Remember, 8GB is more than enough for most of the day-to-day task. But if you are a power user, if you do software development, say for example you are running Android Studio, you are developing apps, you do 4K video editing, so if anything which is like intense CPU and RAM requirement, then you should go with 16 gigabyte of memory. And lastly, the storage. So as I said, there is a M.2 slot which is available, so you can buy an extra SSD and expand the storage. So that means between the cheaper one and the more expensive configuration, 256 versus 512, that's not really relevant because you can buy the cheaper $900 configuration and upgrade the SSD if you desire. So my recommendation is that if you are not going to be using this laptop for some intensive memory related application, like for example software development or 4K video editing, go with the $900 configuration because you can always expand the storage. And I will throw a link in the description of a compatible SSD that you can buy, and I think that will be good enough for you and you will save your $500. Okay, now let's talk about the keyboard. A lot of the thin and light laptops that are in the market, including the fancy Apple MacBook Pros, they have really rubbish keyboard. And the problem is that companies try to shave the distance, like they try to make the key travel very less in order to make the laptop thin and light, and you end up getting a very mushy keyboard. So I'm very happy with the keyboard that Acer has provided here. Even though this is a thin and light laptop, the keyboard actually feels very good when you're typing. The key travel is not as much as the normal laptops, but it is still enough that you do get a good feeling when you type. Similarly, the trackpad is also very nice. It comes with the full Windows 10 precision driver support, so you have the Windows 10 multi-touch, three-finger scrolling, pinch and zoom, all those gestures are supported. Okay, moving on to the ports, which is sometimes lacking in other thin and light laptop. Again, Acer has done a good job with this one. You get plenty of ports. So there is one USB Type-C port, and this one supports the 10 gigabit data connection. It also supports charging through this USB port, and it also has the support for the display port, which means you can hook up a monitor to your laptop using the USB Type-C port if your monitor supports it. And if it doesn't, then that's not a big deal because there is also an HDMI port that you will get. So in addition to these ports, you have the USB 3.0 ports, two of them. So two USB 3.0 port, one USB Type-C port, one HDMI port. I think this is pretty good port selection. So I will throw a link in the description of both the configuration. You can check out the prices. The price do vary. 900 and 1400 is sort of where they hover around, but the prices may go up or down. I hope you found this video useful. And if you like this kind of content, then please consider subscribing to my channel because I cover these kinds of topic. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.